What is going on, YouTubers? Fuminsho here, back at it once again for BE3. Bethesda's
BE3!
There's my boy Matthew, PhenomSage, joining me once again. yeah, it's late at night right now. It's midnight.
They had their conference at a seriously ridiculous hour. I can't believe they are hosting theirs at 12 in the morning. It's just insane.
Yeah.
Also, I'm playing Doom music right now because the music they have on their stream itself got really annoying very fast.
Oh, well, that's what I'm playing. So thanks for throwing shade at me.
Okay.
It was cute for like 5 minutes.
It was cute for the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, and then it got super annoying. It got super annoying real quick. This show, right. I got some expectations. I'm looking forward to this.
I think the one thing, if you saw our Bethesda predictions, you pretty much know what we think about this. But one thing we forgot to mention was Fallout 4 VR. That's definitely appearing here, without a doubt.
We didn't mention The Evil Within 2 either. That's definitely.
Oh yeah. That's right.
Definitely showing up. They had good call.
I forgot to mention.
Do you remember like the Bethesda Land picture they had, where it was like a theme park with like all the different games as attractions?
Yeah.
And I remember Wolfenstein.
Yeah. Evil Within is definitely showing up.
There were two under construction things, and that's definitely Wolfenstein and Evil Within. Those are going to be their two big games they're pushing. I'm excited for them. I'm excited to see what they got. I'm looking for some horror. We haven't seen a horror game yet so far in E3. So.
Yeah.
I'm down.
Some horror greatness.
Yeah, dude, I was watching PT last night, watching playthroughs of PT because I haven't seen it in so long. God, so scary. So scary.
that's a game that will never come out. But
oh, no, it'll never, ever come out. But hopefully Evil Within can bring some kind of horror greatness. Yeah, God, this music's
so annoying. You think Konami... Oh, man, I'm listening to Doom right now? It's the opposite of annoying. That's one thing I want to say right now. If Doom 2 gets announced, Bethesda wins. Bethesda wins. 10 out of 10.
Yeah. But that's the thing. Are they going to capitalize on that success?
Nope. Not this year. But I can dream.
Yeah. I mean, we'll see what happens. Well, it's a surprise. I think Bethesda has some tricks up their sleeve for sure.
I can dream.
We all can dream. It's a definite dream time scenario for a Doom 2.
All right, it's about to start, so I think I'm going to lower this Doom music and play... maybe not. I like Doom too much to lower that music.
I'll let you know when it starts.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm excited for this. Do you think we might get Skyrim Switch? You think they're going to talk about that at all, mention it at all, or you think that's...
Yeah, I think they will, actually. That's a good call, actually. I think they'll mention that. I wonder how much... we'll hear about Switch in Bethesda and Ubisoft coming up.
Oh, I mean, I hope that we get another port of a Bethesda game to Switch. Oh, I think the music stopped.
Oh,
yep, we're going in.
Yep.
Oh, here's a timer. Oh, boy. It's kind of high.
Wow. I could have used that fucking, like, 5 minutes ago.
I'm going to turn the volume up.
It's time.
Oh, these sound effects. This is kind of hype. Let's go.
It's happening.
Let's go. BE3.
That BE3 greatness. Elder Scrolls 6 is not happening, by the way.
Oh, snap. It's happening. Dude, this countdown's super hype.
It just went to zero for you, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay. What the?
There we go. Great. Oh, a nice little jolly dev intro.
What's on his computer?
I don't know. I don't know, actually. He does effects like... Sparkles,
so funny seeing these kids, but like every single game is rated M for Bethesda.
Yeah.
Stuff?
Yeah.
Alright. I'm a senior programmer.
I'm a UI programmer.
I'm a senior designer.
My mom's an artist.
Weird. They're going the Ubisoft route.
I'm a quest designer.
Yeah.
I'm a senior character.
They're going the dev cycle. Oh, what dude, nice tattoos games? There. Yeah. Did you see those tattoos?
That was nice.
The Triforce?
I dreamt of this kind of job when I was a kid.
I grew up loving games.
When he was little, this was actually his dream job.
It never occurred to me that it could be a job.
Sometimes I still feel like that kid.
Wait, I'm an adult?
Sometimes I have to pinch myself that it's real.
I love what I do.
I mean, it's video games for a living. That's gotta be really cool.
Of course.
I like this.
Yeah, I do too.
Nice and feel good.
Excited.
I will say though,
I'm actually working
Quake was better.
I'm working on
it. Oh, yeah.
You're not beating Quake.
Esports.
First person, third person, fantasy.
They might, they could jump into something though. If they jump into something.
Do we know how long this conference is gonna last?
No.
Finally showing everyone our game.
I wish they had said that.
This has been pretty hush hush.
Overwhelming.
Yeah.
I'm really proud of my dad.
My mom worked hard.
And now they're ready.
They made their game, and this is it.
Oh.
Go, Jarn.
Time to show everyone what we've been working on.
What?
Except me. I can't play till I'm older.
Oh.
Awesome. Let's get it started.
Wolfenstein.
Are you ready?
Wolfenstein.
Wolfenstein. So, let's just say New Colossus.
They're starting Wolfenstein.
Showtime.
Showtime. I don't know what showtime is.
All right, this is fun. I like this.
Welcome to the Bethesda E3 Showcase.
That was cool.
That was a good, yeah.
Oh. Oh, it's just a montage.
God.
That was a fun little live action commercial.
Yeah. Fallout 4 greatness. Oh, let's critique the song.
I wish Prey looked that good.
This
song, we're getting copyrighted.
This song is pretty good. I really like this artist. Her voice
I think this is a great intro song to the conference.
Yeah, she's definitely showing her femininity here, but yet still not letting that hold her back. It's rock, and I like that.
Hold her back? Also, get closer to your mic.
All right, I got you.
What do you open him with? Oh!
They're theming their whole show like
Welcome
this?
Welcome everyone to
wow.
Land 2017.
Oh, now it makes
I like
sense
this.
That intro.
Bethesda. I like this.
A place of adventure, innovation, wonderment.
I wish this hadn't gotten leaked.
All else, mm-hmm. Fun.
Doom 2!
To get things started, please welcome Bethesda's Global Vice President of PR and Marketing.
Pete Hines.
My
boy. Oh, dude, look at that font
in
the corner.
Wow, they have a big crowd. Oh, I like that.
Something big is happening here, man. Look at
this
crowd.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I can't even imagine the size of the bar tab that it paid for that applause, but I thank you for that. Good evening and welcome to the 2017 Bethesda E3 Showcase. And welcome to Bethesda Land. We will offer you an experience
I like
at
this
E3
theme. This
unlike
is cool.
Anything else.
I do too.
To
this is fun.
Some of the world's best video games. Tonight we'll be taking you on a virtual tour through our playground where there's something for everyone, whether it's
Doom
phone
2.
Or tablet,
Doom
PC,
2.
Or your favorite Xbox, PlayStation, or Nintendo console, or like many of us, all of the above. But before we turn to the latest from Bethesda, let's take a minute to look at some of the most recent games that you've been playing and many of you are still enjoying, like the endless hours of fun that millions of fans have had playing Doom.
God, Doom looks beautiful.
Doom 2!
And otherwise eviscerating demons.
Or DLC, I'll even take DLC.
Play a badass supernatural assassin in Dishonored 2, or...
Dishonored 2 should have sold
fight
more.
Survive aboard an alien-infested space station in Prey? Maybe you're one of the 100 million people around the world who have enjoyed
God,
building
that install
and overseeing
base is insane.
Your own vault in
Can't believe
Fallout
that game has done that well.
And they capitalized on that Fallout 4 hype.
Yeah.
Fallout 4 and Skyrim Special Edition.
This crowd is real.
Probably because for the first time in our industry, both games offer user mods for console players with more than 300 million mod downloads since we launched them last year.
Wow.
As each of these extraordinary games show, Bethesda works hard for you, giving players the very best entertainment experience regardless of your taste, platform, or playstyle. So, what's next? Let's start by talking about virtual reality.
Oh,
here we go.
Entering in Fallout 4.
Now, we've had teams
Doom VR.
Doom VR.
Doom VR, please.
Doom VR. Do it.
Experience you won't find anywhere else.
Do it.
So let's start our tour of Bethesda Land with two VR games coming out.
Do it.
Fallout and Doom.
You ready?
This crowd is so good.
If you do Doom.
Doom VR.
I swear to Christ. I'm buying a VR headset. Got that Vive greatness.
Take me in. What is this? Is this Doom? Is this Doom? Doom VR! Doom VR! Nice!
It doesn't look like the full game, though. It looks kind of weird.
Maybe it's a special Doom VR game?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, yeah, this is a new experience, I think.
Yeah, what's going on with this?
Is
this doesn't look like... This isn't the Doom VR I wanted.
Take me to hell.
Where's the shooting? Oh, wait. Kinda... I don't know. I kinda just wanted to play with a controller and just, like, play VR in Doom.
Like they're definitely doing, the Vive controllers.
Yeah, it looks like a special, like, Vive exclusive
Doom.
This
is still cool, though. I'm still down for this.
I mean, it's cool, but it's not what I wanted.
VFR.
What was that one clap? Did you hear that?
Yeah.
See, this is what they should have been playing.
Yes, come on. This is cool, man. I want to try this so bad.
See, is this just the full game?
I think it
in
is.
VR?
Yeah, this is the full game. Like, imagine just looking around. Like, I want to see what that looks like.
That'd be fun.
Like, holding... Oh, that's so
cool!
It's like
the F5 integration, though.
Yeah.
I don't think I need that, to be honest. Oh, and I don't like that shakiness. That's the worst part of VR. I would have been fine with just playing with a controller in a VR headset.
I mean, I like that they're putting in as much as they can. You might have the option to use a controller, too.
That would be cool.
This looks hard.
This looks kind of weird.
Okay. Fallout VR. Okay.
All right. I think that's all I need to see on that.
Finally, a full-length open-world game. With near limitless content playable entirely in VR.
Oh, wow.
Sure will be exciting to play Fallout 4 in VR. Plus Doom VFR. It's so hot right now. Expansive
no.
And endless player choice
we're going in.
Are two of the cornerstones.
I like how this is set up, though. I really do.
The Elder Scrolls Online, first released in 2014, and has built a massive community.
It's getting very successful. That Morrowind really pushed that game.
10 million players have had countless
adventures. What did they do with
Morrowind? The new Morrowind pack, it's like a big add-on to the game.
Oh.
Morrowind.
What's up, guys? It's Sam.
It's James.
And it's JV.
It's gonna be exciting.
I'm pretty excited right now.
Here we go.
Is the audio lagging for you?
Yeah, like it's like out of sync.
That was weird.
What the heck? My heart's like racing right now.
Yeah, it's like super out of sync.
That's the stream.
I don't think it's the stream. I think they messed up the.
I mean, like.
Or, yeah, I get what you're saying. Yeah. Oh man, that sucks that they messed up the trailer.
Everybody has said this is what we've been wanting.
This looks pretty, though, for an MMO.
Yeah. It begs you to come home. I like that. That's cool. Every game should do that.
I gotta watch the bear again real quick. Get us on a bear.
God, I love that soundtrack.
Oh, that classic rendition, boys.
Yeah. Imperial City. That was the first DLC. Then they add the Orsinium Thieves Guild.
Oh, man, that's... Elder Scrolls theme is so good.
Oh, yeah.
Wasn't that only for Skyrim, though?
No, it was in Oblivion as well.
Oh, okay.
It's like it's a different rendition of it every time, though. Like they
All right, I like that.
Yeah. Horns of the Reach. Wow, they just keep adding content.
Looks like they got it back in sync.
Clockwork. This looks cool.
Whoa! Oh,
damn, we Transformer boys.
Yeah.
Okay, at least we're getting all the boring stuff out of the way first.
Yeah, I expected a big gear opener, though.
I mean, compared to the last 2 years.
Speaking of Morrowind, did you know
that Morrowind HD remake
user mods in 2002 were for the Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind?
Morrowind HD remaster?
Bethesda continues to support the mod community.
What the
Thomas,
fuck?
Thomas, the tank engine.
Bethesda user mods were made available.
Isn't that trademarked?
And PlayStation 4 players. And since then, there have been more than 300 million mod downloads.
This is kind of cool.
And Skyrim Special Edition. And we're just getting started.
Oh.
In 2017, Bethesda is going to shake things up again.
They're going to show the Switch version?
Bethesda Game Studios is known for creating open living worlds with seemingly limitless gameplay content. But what if there was another way to experience even more, something all new? Introducing Creation Club, a collection of new game content for Skyrim and Fallout 4.
Okay.
Including new weapons. New outfits and accessories. New crafting.
I'm still in.
Using Creation Club is easy. Browse the selection in-game by category.
Oh, this is kind of nice,
use credits to download.
See, this is about what I expected this conference to be.
Automatically. Creation Club content is made by Bethesda Game Studios and outside developers.
I'm hoping the Wolfenstein gameplay is hype.
Mm-hmm.
These outside creators work hand-in-hand with Bethesda Game Studios, which means all content will be fully compatible with your save games, achievements, and official add-ons.
That's cool.
Creation Club is coming this summer for the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC.
And not Switch.
The worlds of Fallout 4
and
Skyrim.
Not Nintendo Switch. Alright, I don't know what the point of that was. Was that really E3?
The Elder Scrolls Legends is another way to explore.
At least they're going by fast.
Yeah.
Taking you beyond the role-playing experience.
I seriously wonder how long this is going to be.
Yeah, I think it's going to be kind of short.
But we haven't.
I think so too. 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Let's see what's next for Legends.
Yay, card game, let's go. Gwent already.
Although, to be fair, you don't get a massive audience like that for a 45-minute conference.
True, true.
I don't know. Maybe there are surprises.
Yeah. It's a good thing Etika went to bed. He probably definitely would have fell asleep during this.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think he'd be interested. Watch Half-Life 3 get announced.
Wait, that's not even Bethesda.
I know.
But we decided to partner up with Valve.
To release Half-Life 3 exclusively.
Does Valve even make games anymore? Does Valve even make games?
No.
Yeah, I don't think they do. But history.
They can, but they don't.
It's pretty abysmal.
Too many of these games on the market, man.
I know.
If I was going to play any of them, I'd probably be playing Hearthstone right now.
I'd kind of go into Gwent, I think.
Or Gwent. Yeah.
This one is the least of my interest, to be honest.
Yeah.
Hearthstone.
It's because there's like, why would you care about Elder Scrolls? There's nothing like recognizable in Elder Scrolls to be like, oh my god, that's a cool card. Whereas like in Gwent, at least you have like tons of recognizable things in that game.
Yeah.
Even those lost amongst the mountains can find their way within the
sky. What is this? Did they automatically transition to something?
I think this is like a Skyrim pack for the card game. For you
to find. Oh, okay. The path to warriors. Wait, they didn't have that already?
I don't know.
The beast's curse by an unquenchable hunger. To scholars of ancient and ferocious magic.
Ferocious magic.
Ferocious magic.
Oh, that's hype right there.
Dude. This has been going on for 20 minutes, and it feels like it just started.
Yeah.
This is weird.
Skyrim card pack.
The Elder Scrolls Legends.
Heroes of Skyrim. Coming, coming soon. Oh, get hype, Matt.
Shadow Drop, get some games.
The Elder Scrolls has given we haven't seen one new game yet.
Yeah, we still haven't seen anything like
worth uploading this video for.
Yeah, seriously. First time, Skyrim. One of our most beloved games. I questioned this, but before we even started this, I was like, why?
Oh, Nintendo Switch?
Yep, they're going to show the Nintendo.
Portable Skyrim, boys. Oh, snap.
Oh, Who the fuck chose this trailer music?
What in the world?
Who the fuck chose this trailer music? This is not.
This is a good band. I really like this artist. No way. Slow down.
What the hell?
No way.
Oh my god. Whoa! Lord. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my good lord. Oh my god. Did you see that?
That was so cool.
Oh my god. Get closer to your mic, dude.
I'm sorry.
I can barely hear you now.
Dude, why did this just get kind of hype all of a sudden? Motion controls.
Why are you so quiet?
It's because I was screaming earlier. It takes a little while for it to get like back to normal.
Oh my god. Bethesda has. All right, that got me hyped. Not gonna lie.
That Master Sword greatness? Which players can tell their
own story. That got me a little bit hyped. Be who they want to be. And do what they want to do.
This September, get ready for another adventure in the Dishonored universe. Dishonored a story DLC? Of revenge
and the ultimate. Dude, you're really quiet.
What? That's. I don't know what happened. I mean, it's still.
Now you're back to normal.
Okay.
That was weird.
Dishonored DLC, boys. What if this is Dishonored 3?
I would have taken Doom DLC over Dishonored.
Oh.
Oh. Wait.
Oh, this is a cool CG trailer, though.
Yeah, this is cool.
Multiplayer?
Oh shit. No, this is DLC. Dad, single player DLC.
It's good to see you, old man.
You up for one last job, Billy?
Who's the mark?
The black-eyed bastard responsible for all the chaos.
Oh.
We're gonna kill
that him. Must mean something for people who played the game.
Death of the Outsider. That's kind of hype. That was a good trailer.
Hype. Played the game.
Yeah.
Didn't really feel anything. Other than that being a cool trailer.
Give me a new game. Come on, B.
In 1996, id Software offered gamers a new exciting way to play and compete. That year marked the true birth of esports. And it began with a LAN party in Dallas, Texas.
Oh, Dallas, Texas represent. Fans came together to play a fast-paced,
revolutionary. Sorry. Oh, Quake.
Called Quake. It offered them a new way to compete.
Finally.
Yeah. Were finally recognized as I'm ready for this.
Gamers. Let's get a release date on this thing. Year,
when do you think Quake it's coming out? Champions takes esports
to the next level. Probably October. October sounds good to me.
Give me some of that clean ass gameplay. Oh no.
We were definitely fall. Champions. We're made. Quake made Champions better. Shadow dropped.
Made faster. Made deadlier.
Alright, I just want to see the game.
Yeah. Match.
We don't just play, we compete.
Okay, come on, show the damn game.
Oh, you think they're gonna show the game? We rise. You're sadly mistaken, my friend.
Until we are quake champions. Yay, black and okay, here we go, here we go. Oh my god, it is beautiful. God, look how fast this game is. Jesus. Yeah, right.
Whoa, hoverboards? Juicy the fuck? Baby.
I love how just wild this game is.
Yeah, I like it too.
The voice acting is just like, the characters are just so weird. You'll regret that. Shields on. She's kind of waifu, that girl.
Oh yeah. Try to keep up. All the games are adding waifus nowadays.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Oh, Daniel Craig!
I'm coming for you, goddamn weirdos. None of you gets out alive.
Daniel Craig!
This looks fun. It all comes down to this. I still am in shock that this every is match, PC exclusive.
Every yeah. Flag, every victory.
More than 20 years in the making, the original eSport returns. Announcing the Quake World Championships, August 26th at QuakeCon in Dallas, Texas.
Oh wow, Dallas, Texas, my boy. Off in the
ultimate oh, you think this game is launching to match that? Their share of $1 million. August?
And the one thing August every champion seeks.
Legacy. What's this thing releasing, boys?
Play the beta now and get ready for the Quake World Championships.
Oh, oh.
Visit Quake.com to
learn more. Okay, so you're not going to give a release date?
Okay. You might notice some parts of Bethesda Land have been oh, finally some new stuff. Now the work is
nearly finished. Let's Wolfenstein. Wolfenstein. Or the Evil Within. Evil Within 2, boys.
Oh wow. It's already creepy it's happening. Too. Immediately I'm frightened. Oh my god.
Yeah.
For 3 years since Beacon happened, you've been searching for answers. You didn't find what you were looking for because
it's a CG trailer though.
Mobius knows you've been following us.
Although they started with gameplay. I've been watching mm-hmm. you for a long time.
You trained and trusted me. And in return, I betrayed you.
What is happening in this game?
I don't know. Did you play the first?
No.
Oh. Oh, spoiler.
She's still alive.
Spoiler.
This is your chance to save her.
Oh, this is cool. What you lost.
Lily needs you. We Doctor Strange boys. You're gonna need to go back into STEM.
Again. I want a full gameplay sequence right now.
Yeah.
If you just give me a trailer, I'll be disappointed.
Oh wow, this is kind of cool though. This is visually, this is really cool.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying this. Whoa. Oh man, this is like a best trailer contender.
Oh yeah. Right here. Yeah, we haven't gotten like a good, like this kind of trailer yet, I feel like.
Yeah, yeah, I agree. Oh, there's gonna be something behind there. Oh, this music choice.
Yeah. So creepy.
I love it. Oh, this is an excellent trailer.
What is that thing? It's like a Polaroid yeah. camera monster.
Yeah. This is frightening. I wish I played the first one now.
Yeah. That's so cool.
Yeah, wow. Oh, wow. What a trailer.
Yeah, that was cool.
Give me gameplay now, please.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is gameplay. Oh, what a... This
looks much better.
God, this is cool. This is an awesome trailer. Give me that great CG greatness and gameplay greatness.
Oh, hell yeah. That's how you do it, boys. Whenever you can do both, do both.
Ooh, what is happening?
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
Oh, that was awesome.
Wow.
Friday the 13th.
October 2017. This game is coming soon.
Isn't that the first protagonist? I think that was the first protagonist there from the first game.
No, you're playing as the first protagonist.
I don't, man, that game looks wild.
That man was the first protagonist.
Evil Within 2 will surely be giving us all nightmares.
It might be time to go play the first one, to be honest.
Yeah, I think so too.
Oh, that's it?
And as we
what?
The end of our tour,
Wolfenstein.
We leave you with one more coming attraction.
Okay. So it's about what we expected.
Yeah.
Wolfenstein and Evil Within being the main standouts.
Here you go, Peggy. Is everything your mother ordered? And a ration card. And here's a Lockridge Necker.
And no Elder Scrolls 6.
Well, gee, thanks, Mr. Wilson.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Wilson.
Hi, Peggy.
Hi, Bill.
This is amazing.
What?
I'm gonna get you out.
Get it off.
Hang on.
I'm busy. I can't come out right now. I'm busy.
What the?
I think that's one of the enemies. Did she just say kill?
Yeah.
Oh, help.
What is this? Liesel?
Good nutrition is a matter of state security.
I really like how this is presented right now.
Welcome back to round three. Now is where
German or else?
Okay, hands on your buzzers. Here we go.
The honorable you would exercise self-control.
Just illegal.
Fallout 5 confirmed.
No, this is Wolfenstein.
Oh,
this music.
Oh, no. Oh, my God, no.
What?
Is this the Fallout from, what is it?
No way. No way. No way.
No way. This is, I think this might be. Although, that looks like a Wolfenstein main character.
Yeah.
That looks like what I would expect. Why is that Obsidian? That's her name.
Yeah.
Obsidian. But no, I'm pretty sure this is Wolfenstein. Fallout will never look this good.
In a CG trailer, it will. Jesus. So bad.
Zet says we're having twins.
Frau Engel. She's been hunting for you. She's been moving heaven and earth, and today she found you.
You think?
Oh, this is.
Yeah, totally Wolfenstein. You see that swastika?
Yeah. Oh, this is in game.
It looks nice.
Oh,
monsters did this.
Not monsters.
Oh my god. This wow. is disturbing. Wow.
Hello?
Come on, Peter. Let's go someplace else.
Mom,
no buts.
Oh. Bitte schön.
Danke. Come on.
This is disturbing. I don't like this.
One strawberry, I love this. Shake,
please. No, I love it, but man, it's scary.
Oh, I hope you don't have a fire back there to put out.
If so, I'll come back another time.
I'm sure the fire can wait, Commandant. One strawberry milkshake coming right up.
Fireman, I recognize your face. Very Aryan face it is too. Are you out of Station 1?
There you go, Commandant.
Oh, vielen Dank. Now you.
Wow.
Show me your identification papers.
Oh.
Please.
Oh, wow.
We gotta put the fighting spirit back in the American people.
You shoot on us! Smart!
What is that? This is like some Kojima stuff right here.
Just who the fuck are you? I love the, like, transition between scenes.
Yeah.
That I am not a Nazi.
Wait, what you say? You say you're Nazi?
Fuck this.
Motherfucker!
Let me say this again. I ain't no goddamn Nazi.
Hey!
Now you bring Super Special back in and you put him down right now, or I will shove this grenade so far up your ass.
Lady, I got precious little time for your bullshit. We've been trying to make contact with your group. We're organizing for a revolution in America.
We? Shit!
Take cover!
Relax, man. It's just a duck.
Oh, he's got a sick sense of humor.
For the longest time, I've been hearing through the grapevine about this resistance. Leader. Named. Horton.
You know, my ma always said, never trust a man can't handle his whiskey, so you sit right there.
This is a really nice unveiling.
Yeah. Spicing in gameplay with CG. With...
Yeah.
I respect your ambition, but there's nothing can be done no more. The world has sank into the crapper, and all we can do now is drink this whiskey and watch the vortex suck it all down.
Didn't expect your belly to be quite so yet.
I think this is in game.
Oh, are you kidding me? Of course it is.
Yeah.
Of America and the greedy money men of Wall Street who was itching to send the children of the proletariat off to die in foreign lands so that they could be filling.
Who keeps shooting?
It worked their sons bleeding on the beaches.
I got kids on the way. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna raise them in a world run by these Nazi assholes.
You take freedom away from the American people, you're playing with fire. And I intend to pour some gasoline.
Oh. This is badass. I like this. Oh my god.
Oh, here we go. Some gameplay. Oh, look at this.
This looks sweet.
This looks awesome. And I know it will look this good.
Yeah.
Jeez. New Order looks awesome.
This music. Oh my god, what was that?
Look at that enemy! Look at these bosses! Wow.
This weapon design.
This game!
Crocodiles? Oh man, this is awesome.
This is incredible. Wow.
Please be coming out this year.
Please. It looks almost finished.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh,
yes!
It's just called Sign 2.
Yes.
And it is.
Yes. Oh,
wow,
good.
Those two games are coming out so close together.
Man, Bethesda, they're pushing. What the?
Hey, little fella. What are you doing?
What?
He like, I think he like took some drug or something.
What? That's amazing.
That was a good reveal. That was good.
Game of show. Game of this show, anyways.
Yeah. It is good.
I said a couple of months ago that the thing that Machine Games was working on is fucking bananas, so now you know what I mean by fucking bananas. A lady pregnant with twins stabbing a Nazi while a guy is dropping acid is fucking bananas. We can't wait to more show to show you guys more of Wolfenstein 2 and how it combines the compelling shooter.
That game is coming out soon.
Story, I know.
Unforgettable characters.
Bethesda is so good at doing this. Announcing games, releasing them. Our booth this week
at E3, I love that.
You have a chance to go hands-on and begin the fight to rally the resistance in America against the Nazi regime. In addition to Wolfenstein 2, we'll have hands-on for our VR titles, so you can play both Fallout 4
and Doom VFR. They got some show floor greatness too.
You can play Quake Champions and start practicing.
I'm interested to hear what people think of Doom VR on the show floor.
The new Elder Scrolls Online Morrowind. Plus, we have hands-on for the new Heroes of Skyrim for Legends, plus a cool interactive experience for The Evil Within 2, exclusive develop interviews.
Is that Riff Tracks?
And a lot more.
I don't know.
We hope you're excited.
I think that was a Riff Tracks reference.
As we are. Again, a reminder, everything that you saw tonight will be out this
year. Awesome.
Yeah, that's cool the way they focused on that. I like that.
Be it mobile, I'm glad. PC, console, or
although I
reality,
still would have liked to see an Elder Scrolls 6
tease.
Bethesda remain the place to go for the very best in video games. We hope you've enjoyed this evening's showcase. It's your passion and excitement that drives our teams to make.
I like Pete Hines a lot, actually.
Exciting.
Super just genuine.
Yeah, me too.
If you're here at E3, we hope you'll come by the booth and say hi. If you're not here in LA, please keep checking BethesdaNet, where we'll have lots more to say about the games you saw tonight in the coming days, weeks, and months. And we thank all of you online for joining us. Please have a good night.
I like this one. This one was super short.
It was streamlined. They streamlined it. I like
streamlined
it.
And short.
Yeah. See you next time, BE3. Yeah, it was a good little show. You want to do a little talking about real quick?
Yeah, just a quick little discussion.
I wonder what
I liked.
What?
I liked, before Wolfenstein, it was sitting at a 6 out of 10 for me.
Yeah.
I think that bumped it up to a 7
I think it did, too, exactly for me, too. I think the fact that it was short, it wasn't necessarily boring. Like, it wasn't like, oh, nothing was, like, boring, really.
They, like, cut a lot to what they needed to. It was nice and streamlined. Won't take a long time to upload, thank Christ.
Yeah. It was a good little show. Good little show. So far, Microsoft's on top. This is number 2. I think that's going to change tomorrow, but...
Yep, Microsoft's top, Bethesda 2, EA obviously last.
Yeah. But the fact that Evil Within and Wolfenstein, two basically brand new games never before seen, are both
those games
coming
are
out the same
They're coming
month.
Out within 2 weeks.
That's insane.
Within
2 weeks
of each other.
Bethesda's so good at doing this, where they just announce games.
You think that was a wise decision?
I think they're both. I don't know, man. I don't know what.
I feel like they could have pushed Wolfenstein to
November. Yeah, I don't know, but I mean, I mean,
I don't care.
I don't care either. I think I might be picking up Wolfenstein, man. That game looks insanely good.
Dude, yes.
Give me that right now. That looks so great. Those boss fights. The graphics look so good. I'm totally down for that. And same thing with Evil Within. Like, two sequels to games that I never played, but yet I want to now because of how hype those games look. And that's good, the way they did that. Also, amiibo support.
Oh, yeah, that Zelda amiibo, like, really got me excited.
We're gonna see more of that during Treehouse, I feel like, where they talk a little more about it. That was cool. Seeing that Master Sword in there. That was cool. I hope there's more. Like, if you throw a Mario one down, you get like a Mario hammer
or something.
I hope there's more than just Zelda. But I mean, that was a cool little showcase. Good little trailer.
That was a nice little thing.
Yeah.
I think that's really all the showcases, though.
The motion controls were a little like. I mean, I'm not super into motion controls, but the fact that they're there is pretty cool too.
And I'm like, we already discussed this, but I feel like I would have been fine with just VR and then just using a controller.
Oh no! I meant in the Switch version, having motion controls in the Switch version was kind of cool.
Oh, did they show? I didn't even notice that.
Yeah, they have straight up motion controls in there. with the bow and the sword. Like, I thought that was
interesting.
I thought that was pretty cool. And you know,
that was a nice little addition.
Yeah. So I don't know if I'm picking that up. Who knows? Maybe.
We'll see. I remember you were like, "Oh, please don't show that."
I mean, yeah, I don't know. I'm just Skyrim's so boring to me now. Like, it's just it's hard, but throwing in the Master Sword helps a little bit. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. All in all, a good show. I think we're pretty much done here, right?
Yep, I think that's it. We covered it was a nice little short show, covered it in a nice little short discussion.
Yeah, thank you guys.
So, final rating, like somewhere in between 6 and 7.
I think I just give it straight up 7. I'll give it 7 out of 10. It wasn't terrible, wasn't amazing, but they showed two great games. Two great games that are like honestly contenders for best of show, in my opinion.
And GOTY. We might be seeing one of those GOTY.
I didn't even
discussion.
Think about that. Oh man, Wolfenstein for sure. Without it,
Wolfenstein does look like GOTY material.
It does. It really does. That's a whole other discussion to be had. Yeah, thank you guys very much for watching. Make sure to comment down below and give us your thoughts on what was shown during this showcase. And also, please be sure to hit that like button. Hit it hard. Real hard.
You don't have to.
Hit the dislike button.
Just hit it
soft. Just please hit the dislike button. If I get 100 dislikes, I'm shaving my head. also please be just sure to subscribe, of course. Subscribe to me and PhenomSage for more E3 content. Reactions are going to be up the wazoo. We have PlayStation and Ubisoft tomorrow. I'm looking forward to both of those
press conferences. Yeah, me too, actually.
And Nintendo the next day, which is starting to sound a little more hype than I think we both anticipated. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching. And as always, I'm going to let my good friend Matthew do the final send-off.
Vusroda!